In this tutorial, you take a look at setting active shade mode in a viewport and reducing floating window clutter in the process. Active shade mode is not really a final render technique, more like a testing process. In active shade mode, changes to the scene such as fine-tuning materials, lights, and camera placements are updated live. Open the scene named ActiveShade.max you downloaded for this tutorial. A download link is provided in the description section of this movie. It's a simple scene with a shader ball model, three photometric lights, and a physical camera. The materials used in the scene are based on the new physical material that was introduced in 3ds Max 2017. So in fact, you need that version of 3ds Max or newer to be able to open the scene. The new physical material has a clean and intuitive interface, which makes it easy to create any real-world materials you can think of. As its name implies, it is a physically based material that you are encouraged to use in your future designs. There is a tutorial on this channel named Understanding the Physical Material that can help you explore its capabilities. The new physical material is compatible with most rendering engines, including Scanline. To get the most out of it, though, you should use it in conjunction with the new Art Renderer. Currently, and judging by the Render Settings dialog, the active renderer is still based on Scanline. The Scanline renderer is old technology and is limited in its possibilities. Switch the rendering engine to Art Renderer. Art Renderer also is a new feature of 3ds Max 2017, much like the new physical material. If you test render again, you'll notice a significant improvement using Art Renderer over Scanline. Art Renderer is a progressive renderer. If the results feel too grainy for now, it's because the default rendering is set to draft. More on that in a moment. The goal here is to eliminate the floating rendering window completely and display the rendering inside a viewport. This is where ActiveShade shines. In the Render Setup dialog, change the target option to read ActiveShade Mode. Note that changing the target mode sets you back to the Scanline renderer, so make sure you switch back to Art Renderer yet again. To fix the issue of grainy renders, go to the Art Renderer tab and set the render quality to max. Since Art is a progressive renderer, it will keep improving the render results unless you stop it or make a change to the scene. You can dismiss the previous render image and try a new test render. The ActiveShade window is slightly different as it updates with every change. To test that, use the camera orbit or dolly tools to change the camera position and notice the change in the ActiveShade window as well. Let's do one better by setting ActiveShade in a viewport so that the floating render window doesn't clutter the UI. Dismiss the ActiveShade window and the Render Setup dialog. Click the Physical Camera 01 label and choose Extended Viewports, ActiveShade. Instead of a floating window, the progressive render results are now directly viewed in the viewport. You may want to resize the viewport to get a better look at the model. Unlike regular viewports where you can zoom, pan, and orbit, the ActiveShade viewport is locked. At any time, you can exit this mode using a right click and then close. To have the ActiveShade viewport react to a camera change, you can set another viewport to use that same camera. Switch the front view to the same physical camera 01 and set the original camera viewport to use ActiveShade again. This time, as you orbit or dolly the smaller camera viewport, the changes are updated live in ActiveShade. Changes are updated if you edit the lights in the scene, such as when you move them around, and ultimately, a change to the applied material is also updated live in ActiveShade. It makes this mode extremely useful as you test out a scene. When you're ready to explore the physical material, you'll be making extensive use of the ActiveShade and Viewport mode. To learn about that, watch the tutorial named Understanding the Physical Material on this channel.